belongs to you. In heaven and the earth, all power belongs to you. Power belongs to you, Jesus. Power belongs to you. In heaven and the earth, all power belongs to you. Power belongs to Jesus. Power belongs to you, King of Kings. Power belongs to you. In heaven and the earth, all power belongs to you. Jehovah, you are the Most High. Jehovah, you are the Most High God. Jehovah, you are the Most High. Jehovah Nissi,
you are the Most High God.
El Shaddai, you are the Most High.
You are the Most High God.
Jehovah,
you are the Most High.
Sing more songs.
Eria toso fratiste riande la mosi e franani ake. Ni franga zuste riati da mosi e fraharia. Ni frage piasa siria. He says, oh, give thanks to the Lord for he is good. And his mercy is endure forever. Ni fradose frate riasa stera bobo rosia. Ni franga zaste riati di mosi aha. E fracatisto ornite riande la mosi ake. E siata la vosia, e fratose frecetista la vostra frietere mosia, e fratiste riatara vostra frecateria sostere minge riandolo motia. Thank you, Father God, we give you praise and glory. In Jesus' name we've prayed. Father, we give you praise as we go into your word this afternoon. We ask for the spirit of wisdom and revelation of you, that the eyes of our hearts be flooded with light in the name of Jesus. Thou might know what the hope of your calling is and what are the riches of the glory of your inheritance in the saints, and what the exceeding greatness of your power may be able to also believe. I ask in the name of Jesus that you fill us with the knowledge of your will concerning our healing and health, in all wisdom, strong understanding. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. We can have a seat. Good afternoon. This is Rema Nigeria Daily Healing School. Those on site and online, good afternoon. Good afternoon. You're welcome too. Hallelujah. I just want to say again and confess that greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. That I speak and minister with the ability of God because I depend on the greater one on my inside. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name forever. Amen. So we've been talking for some time about, well, Dr. Chichi came 2 weeks ago and talked about the power in God's word, how efficacious, how powerful God's word is. And then Dr. Tadi came last week and more or less continued on the power of the word of God. And God's power in the word can heal. And it emphasized the place of our confession. Confessing God's word, how to take God's word into our hearts and into our body and let it affect our body. But yesterday, I was meant to start a new series this week, Methods of Obtaining Healing. But I just retitled it. I called it How to Pray and Receive Answers. But we're still going for the next 2 or 3 weeks, so there's no problem. So I'm really sharing on today a bit on how to pray and receive answers. But I'm just giving a different tattoo. I'm still going to focus it on receiving healing. Praise God. Hallelujah. So you can give it anything. You can call out to pray and receive answers. You can call it methods of obtaining healing. Whichever way, that's what we're going to focus on. And I'm going to start with something again. Remember yesterday, I came here yesterday. I've been preparing. I came here and I couldn't really teach. We just prayed. I couldn't really teach. I shared for like just 10 or 15 minutes, then we closed, then we went offline, then we prayed, those that were here physically. And so, some things came through my mind, and those are the theme of things I believe people will receive answers to while taking this series. Praise God. Hallelujah. You might be there watching me, you've been sick for a long time. It seems you've done everything you know to do. Then you're wondering, why am I not seeing the manifestation of my healing? You receive answers in this series. Hallelujah. And not just receive answers, you act on it and you take your healing. That's what matters most. Amen. So I started with saying that. Healing, your healing is always God's will. Why have we spent so much time on that? Because the first step to receiving anything from God is just first find out what is his will. The first step to receiving anything from God is first to find out what is his will in the matter. I'm married. I have a ring in my hand. I cannot come here now and say that, okay, I claim a sister for my wife. I'm already married. Praise God. Bragging went somewhere to preach, and someone said he wanted to see the pastor. He said he wanted the pastor and him to go and pray all night in the church because he wanted to pray to see whether God was good, whether it was God's will for him. He was married, though, to take another man's wife as his own. Hallelujah. And the pastor told him that don't waste your time praying. It can never be the will of God. Bible says you should not covet your neighbor's wife. He said, if Romans chapter 13 says it, that love will not walk any heel towards his neighbor. Love is fulfillment of law. So you should not covet your neighbor's wife. But the man still went and prayed all night. And God had mercy on him. That when he finished praying, he heard God say no. Hallelujah. Because God doesn't need to answer that kind of question because he's already answered it in his word. Praise God. We cannot go and pray now that if I should embezzle money and pray whether it is your will that I should embezzle money and do preferred government. is ready in his word. Hallelujah, that we should not do that. Thou shalt not steal. I shall not go and pray, Lord, maybe I should lie when they ask me this question about, no, he's ready in his word. We should speak the truth to our neighbor. So some things are clear in the Bible. So the first step, especially when it's the prayer of faith, we're talking about a prayer that changes things, the prayer that I receive from God, I'm focusing on the area of healing. We must first find out what is the will of God in the matter. What is God saying about the matter? That is why we took time to check 1 John chapter 5 to establish over and over again. I'm still going to see some more 2 points about it. That healing is all, your healing is always the will of God. 1 John chapter 5 verse 14. And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desired of him. If we know that he hears us. John chapter 15 verse 7. Hallelujah. Before we pray about anything, find out what is the will of God. Now, there are some things like it's not written in the Bible. It's not written in the Bible clearly that Shemfana will say move to Canada with your family. Hallelujah. So if and a thought comes to my mind, I'm thinking of moving to Canada, I have to pray about it. Lord, is it your will for me to move to Canada? If it is your will. In that kind of prayer, I can pray if it is your will because I don't know his will. Praise God. So people, an offer has come some time ago. Somebody offered me something. An opportunity offered my family an opportunity, and I looked at it. Well, I checked my heart. I prayed about it. There was nothing even gripping about it in my heart. So I knew it wasn't God's will. Praise God. Hallelujah. I've been offered this the Canada trip I'm talking about. I've been offered about 15 years ago. I was offered on a platter of gold, but I prayed about it. I said, no, God wanted me to be in Nigeria. Hallelujah. So what am I saying? In that kind of case, you must find out if it be thy will. If it be thy will. That's what Jesus prayed in the Garden of Gethsemane. He said, Lord, if it is your will, let this cup pass over me. Not my will, nevertheless, but your will be done. That is when we are, it's something that concerns the will of God as per our life, God's plan for our lives. It's a prayer of consecration. Lord, I want to, and we all pray it every day. Lord, if you send me back to Oshobo, I will go. If you send me even to the village, if you send me to Sambisa Forest, I will go. We must always pray that prayer for us to stay tender before God. God, you send me to a village and to go and preach the gospel and live there for the rest of my life. Your will be done. Hallelujah. Lord, you want me to locate? Your will be done. You want me to do? Your will be done. That is a prayer we must all pray. We must have a tender heart towards God. So, why some people get into trouble? Is that we have been so stubborn in an area. Hallelujah. Some people get into trouble just because of stubbornness. Why not just open it and pray, Father, if it is your will, I will do it. All I need to know it is your will. Your will is my command. That's all I need to know. That's the example Jesus gave us. He said, if it is possible. Mark chapter 14. It says, Abba, Father, all things are possible with you. Yeah, we prayed that for the prayer of consecration. It's Mark chapter 14, I believe, yes. I'll soon get the verse. It's Mark chapter 14. It says, Abba, Father, all things are possible with you. If it is possible, let this will pass over me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. Hallelujah. Mark chapter 14. They led Jesus, before they led him away at all, he went to pray. Hallelujah. I'm coming, I'll soon be there. Yes, Mount Olives. He said, and Jesus said unto them, it's 34 if I remember. Yes, it's 34. And said unto them, my soul is exceeding sorrowful unto death. Tarry ye here and watch. And he went forward and a little and fell on the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. And he said, Abba, Father, all things are possible unto thee. Take away this cup from me. Nevertheless, not what I will, but what thou wilt. You can pray that in this case where it's a prayer. We call this a prayer of consecration to do the will of God. Lord, I will do your will, whatever you say. Praise God. A man of God was a man, where I'm bragging, gave the story of a man that was got born again as a teenager, as a young man, and he felt God wanted to call him to go to China. Then people used to go to China for missionary trips in the 40s, 50s. Of 1940s, 50s, go to China. I thought God wanted me to go to China, and he ran away from the thought because he didn't want to go to China. And he stopped being close to God. And he was not close to God for years. But one day he came to church and there was a crusade. And he just said, let me just get rid of this thing. Just went to the altar. Lord, I'm laying all on the altar. If you want me to go to China, I will go. And the Lord said, I never wanted you to go to China. I only wanted you to be willing. I only wanted you to be willing to do whatever. Because as a saying, we say that people say, if he's not Lord of all, he's not Lord at all. There's no half Lord. There's no half Lordship. If he's either Lord of all or none at all. If he's not Lord of all, as Greg will put it, say, if Jesus is the Lord of your life, he must have a say in whatever you do, in the company you keep, in the entertainment you, in the job you do, in the entertainment you, in the company, in the entertainment you expose yourself to, in every area. He said, if he's Lord, he wants to have a say in every nook and cranny of your life. But you know, he said that is the secret to supernatural life, when you make him Lord. So that is when we pray the prayer of consecration. But today we are not talking about the prayer of consecration. We are talking about a prayer of faith, when we are taking something from God. John chapter 15, verse 7. I'm focusing on healing. It's just another way of saying methods of training. I just feel like it's just change the tweak, the title a bit, no problem. John 15, verse 7. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and shall be done unto you. No, Bible says, study, show yourself approved unto God. A workman that needs not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. If you just take that scripture half and says that you shall ask what you will and it shall be done to you. No, that's not what Jesus said. Jesus said, if you abide in me and my words abide in you. Why is he saying that? Because if his words abide, if you abide in him where you're born again, and your words abide and his words abide in us, you will ask according to his will. You ask based on his word that abides in you. Because if his word abides in you, you know that he has already said, thou shalt not steal. You won't ask him for wisdom to go and commit armed robbery. You won't ask him for wisdom for that. Hallelujah. You not ask him to help him punish your enemy. Because the Bible said, love you. And Jesus said, love your enemies. Bless them that curse you. Do good to them that hate you. And pray for those who despitefully use you and persecute you. So if his words abide in you, you won't ask your enemy. You won't pray for him to deal with your enemy. No, you will pray for him to have mercy on them. Open their eyes to see the truth. That's all you will pray if you have enemies at all. Praise God. Hallelujah. So we must first establish what does the word say about the matter. What is the will of God is a matter. And I will say half of this problem is solved when we have established that. What is the will of God in this matter? Mark chapter 1. This man came to meet Jesus. He said, if you are willing. The man had leprosy. Verse 40. He said, if you are willing, you can make me clean. The Jesus that is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Mark chapter 1, verse 40. And there came a leper to him, beseeching him and kneeling down to him and saying unto him, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. And Jesus moved with compassion, put forth his hand, and touched him and said unto him, I will be thou clean. That's what Jesus said. I will be thou clean. So from this man's experience, we are knowing the will of God. And the Bible says Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, forever. You might want the fruit of the womb. There might be anything you want. The Bible says, Luke chapter 1, verse 37. For with God, nothing shall be impossible. With God, nothing shall be impossible. Matthew chapter 19, verse 26. For with God, all things, not some things, all things are possible. Much more when we know his will in his word. So the first thing is I find out what is his will. And we have said it. What is it? We said, number one, concerning healing. I was going to mention 9 points. I said, well, number one, that because God is good, oh, give thanks a lot for his good, his mercies endure forever. He is good, his mercies endure forever. So, and healing is sickness is not good. Healing is good. Paul says, our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, were about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of devil, for God was with him. And Jesus said, he that has seen me has seen the Father. So God is good, and in his goodness, he brings healing to people's body. Number two, we said, because God is love. Lamentations chapter 3 says, it is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed. Verse 22. The steadfast love is of Lord mercy, we are not consumed. His mercies, his compassions fail not. His mercy never come to an end. Let me read it. Because I keep quoting the RSV plus the KJV together. So, Lamentations chapter 3, verse 22. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The RSV says that, that's the Revised Standard Version, says that the steadfast love of the Lord, that song we sing, never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. So he said, the steadfast love of the Lord never. So his love is steadfast. He's a loving father. When he healed the madman of Gadara, the man said, I want to follow you. He said, no, go and tell the people how great things the Lord has done to you. How he has had compassion on you. So when God has compassion, he heals. Is that not so? Jesus had compassion all over the Bible. Matthew chapter 14, verse 14. Jesus had compassion on them. He expressed his love towards them and he healed their sick. Because he's a God of compassion, he wants you well. Number three, which we now normally say, we say number three because healing is a part of redemption. But I always like to say that number two first, because the motive behind redemption is the love and compassion of God. Healing is a part of redemption. Isaiah 53, verse 4 and 5. Surely he had borne our sicknesses and carried our pains. Yet we are deeply stricken as men of God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. With his stripes we are healed. 1 Peter 2:24. Who his own self bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, being dead to sins, may live unto righteousness. By whose stripes you were healed. That's where, past tense now. Matthew 8:17, verse 16 says that he healed everyone that was sick. He healed them all, that he might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. So we are sure of that. That healing is God's will, because healing is a part of redemption. When Jesus took our sins, he carried our sicknesses too. Because there was no sickness in the Garden of Eden. If he had gone to tell Adam, when he was in the Garden of Eden, I have a headache. He would say, what do they call headache? Because he doesn't know. There is nothing. He has never experienced it before. He didn't exist. By one man's offense. Romans chapter 5 verse 12. By one man's, just one man. Wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. By one man sin entered the world. So, cancer didn't exist in the Garden of Eden. Hallelujah. I'm so happy that Jesus said in the beginning it was not so. There are many things that were not so in the beginning. And he has brought us back to somewhere better than the beginning now. Hallelujah. I'm so happy that some things were not. Jesus said in the beginning, if you're talking about divorce culture, but I like that phrase. A lot of things were not so in the beginning. There was no cancer in the Garden of Eden. There was no unfruitfulness in the Garden of Eden. He said, be fruitful and multiply. Settled. Chicken, huh? And replenish the earth. And what he has written. So that's number one. Find out the will of God. So we said healing is always God's will because, number two, because sickness comes from Satan. Acts 10:38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed, therefore God was with him. And we have only one ministry with the devil in the New Testament. He didn't say romance the devil. He didn't say receive the devil. He didn't say welcome the devil. See what accent it says. Our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth, the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. He didn't say romance the devil. Please give me James chapter 4, verse 7. He didn't say entertain the devil. He didn't say do good to the devil. He said resist the devil and we flee from you. So that means everything, you see, John Gilliga said that when I found that sickness comes from Satan, he said everything in me rose up against the work of the devil. Submit yourselves therefore to God and resist the devil and he will flee from you. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 27. Ephesians 4 27. He said, and give no place to the devil. Ephesians 4 27. So we are to resist the devil. That is what we should do. So no, healing is God's will. Because sickness comes from the devil. Neither give place to the devil. Number three, we say we know healing is God's will because healing was provided both in the Old Testament and in the New Testament. That's number five now. Healing was provided both in the Old Testament and the New Testament. Because in the Old Testament, he said in Exodus 15:26, I am the Lord that healed thee. I am the Lord your physician. And he has not changed. I am the Lord your physician. And he expressed all these blessings because of Abraham, their father. The only reason why they were delivered from Egypt was because God promised Abraham that somebody is going to, a country is going to carry your have your seeds as slaves for 400 years in Genesis 15. But I will come back and deliver them and I will deal with that country. So when he came back and delivered them, he was just fulfilling the promise he gave Abraham. Hallelujah. And Galatians chapter 3 verse 13 now says that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangs on a tree, that the blessing that God gave Abraham might come upon the Gentiles through Christ Jesus. You know, with that scripture alone, you can kill any kind of cancer. You can walk out free from unfruitfulness, from any kind of cancer, any kind of infirmity. It says, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, Galatians 3, 13 and 14. For it is written, cursed is everyone that hangs on a tree, verse 14, that the blessing of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles. What did he promise Abraham and his seed? Verse 29, let's go to verse 29. So you know that he's not talking about Abraham alone. Hallelujah. Genesis 23, verse 29. And if he be Christ, then are ye Abraham's seed, and he hears according to the promise. Please give me verse 27. I want to read from verse 27. I'll read from Galatians 3:27. For as many of you have been baptized into Christ and put on Christ, verse 28, there is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither bond nor free, there is neither male nor female, for ye are all one in Christ Jesus. Look at verse 29 now. And if ye be Christ, then are you Abraham's children or Abraham's seed, and not just Abraham's seed by mouth, and heirs according to the promise. Here's according to be promise. Hallelujah. Praise God. Here's according to be promise. So we have got the promise that God, all the blessing that God gave Abraham. He said that the blessing of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles through Christ Jesus. Paul said in Ephesians chapter 2 that we're strangers from the commonwealth of Israel. Aliens to the strangers to the covenants of promise. Aliens from the commonwealth of Israel. But we are no longer strangers. We are no longer strangers. That's why it's the same thing. That we have now got the blessing. We are no longer strangers. We are no longer foreigners. We are fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God. Psalm 105 verse 37. Healing in the New Testament, in the Old Testament. Psalm 105 verse 37. He says, he brought them forth with silver and gold, and there was not one feeble person among their tribe. What am I doing again? I'm reinforcing, reestablishing and reinforcing the fact that your healing is God's will because you are a child of Abraham. He brought them forth with silver and gold, and there was not one feeble person. Nobody with a weak kidney, with a weak bladder, with a weak kidney, with a weak pancreas. Not one weak person. That word feeble is also the word weak. Not one weak person among their tribe. If somebody has a weak kidney, he is weak. You'll be depending on dialysis maybe twice or thrice a week. Hallelujah. So there's not one feeble, not one weak person among their tribe. That means their kidneys were not hip, their hearts were, everybody's heart was strong, their lungs were not perforated. Their intestine was strong, they didn't have ulcer. Not one weak person among their tribe. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 4. Verse 3 says that I might teach you that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from God. Now look at verse 4. He said, these 40 years in the wilderness, he said, your feet did not, Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 4. Your feet did not grow blisters. Your raiment waxed not old upon thee. Neither did thy foot swell these 40 years. Just verse 4. Just verse 4, please. Just verse 4. Can you give it to me in NIV? New International Version. This KJV. Yes. Your clothes did not wear out and your feet did not swell during these 40 years in the wilderness. Because he had promised Exodus 15, 26, as we're crossing the Red Sea. I am the Lord that healed thee. I am the Lord your physician. The Bible says, if the ministration of death was glorious, the ministration of death was glorious, how much must the ministration of life exceed in glory? If people could live in the Old Testament and there was not one sick person among their tribe, How much more in the New Testament? If the mystery of death was glorious, how much more shall the mystery of life exceed in glory? In the Old Testament, Elisha was a prophet, and this lady was taken as a slave to the city, to Samaria, and she told her elder, madam, that I wish to God that my boss, our God, Naaman, the man that was leprous, will visit Naaman the Syrian, will visit Israel, the prophet in Israel who will be healed. So there were healing ministries in the Old Testament. People were getting healed. That's what it means. How would she have known, if not that she had seen people get healed under Elisha's ministry? If the mystery of death is glorious, how much more shall the mystery of life exceed in glory? So you see, what am I saying? I'm proving my case again beyond reasonable and unreasonable that it is God's will for you to be healed. Because the first thing to receiving from God anything is just find out what is God's will. 3 John 2, healing in the Old and the New Testament. He says, beloved, I wish above all things that you prosper and you be in health, even as your soul prospers. I wish, it is my desire, my prayer above all things, that you prosper and you be in health, even as your soul prospers. That is what I want for you in the New Testament. Now, James chapter 5, verse 14 and 15. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church. Let them pray over him, anointing with all the name of the Lord. And the prayer of which shall save the sick, the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed any sins, they shall be forgiven. People believe that when they confess our sins, they are forgiven. Is that not so? But this same scripture says, is any sick, his Lord will raise him up and his sins will be forgiven. The God that said he will forgive sins said he will raise him up also. Hallelujah. So if you believe that when you pray, when you use 1 John 1, 9, your sins, if you made a mistake, you made a mistake, well, Father, I'm sorry, but also if you confess our sins, I confess my sins, I'm sorry in the name of Jesus. He said, be faithful and just forgive our sins, cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And the same scripture says that the Lord will raise him up. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise his own name. So people are going to get healed today. People are going to take their healing. We are going to take our healing this week. For the rest of them, we're just going to share our methods of obtaining it. Different. We're going to come from different angles. We are going to take our healing. So that was number three. That was number five. Well, 2 + 3, that was number five. So number six says that is that Jesus was the will of God in action. What am I doing? I'm reinforcing your conviction. Because you see, there's one thing, there are people that you've been facing these symptoms. You've done all you seem to know to do. The Bible says, I haven't done all to stand, you should stand. Well, I've done all the things I want to do, but I'm not being healed. It is not God's will. No, that's what happened in Matthew chapter 17. And that's where we end up by the grace of God. Matthew 17, we end up there. No, let's go there yet. So, because Jesus was the will of God in action, John, then just use two scriptures. Acts 10:38. Our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth, the Holy Ghost and the power. When about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Acts 10:38. Our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth, the Holy Ghost and with power. When about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. This shows that this is God's will. And this also was the will of God in action. Let's do some more. John chapter 15. Let's go some further. Let's go further. No problem. John chapter 15. Let's do some scriptures. Verse 19, and then I'll read verse 30 also. Jesus, the will of God. Hallelujah. In action. John chapter 15. Okay, I didn't write it down. Verse 19. Give it to me. Okay, I got it here. Then, verse 19. You got, thank you. If you were of the world would love his own. But because you are not of, John chapter 5, verse 19. Sorry, not 15. No. John chapter 5, verse 19. Then answered Jesus and said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, the Son can do nothing of himself, but what he said the Father do, for what things soever he doeth, this also doeth the Son likewise. So Jesus kept doing only what he saw the Father doing. John 5:19. That's what he's saying. Hebrews chapter 1 says that, verse 3 says that God who at sundry, verse 1, chapter 1 says, God who at sundry times and in divers manner spoke to our fathers by the prophets, and his in latter spoken to us by his Son. But almost so he made the world, who being the brightness of his glory, verse 3, and the express image of his person. What was he saying? He was saying, the writer of Hebrew was saying that if you've seen Jesus, you've seen the Father. the express image of this person. John chapter 14, verse 9, the one I like so much to use. Verse 9 alone, Jesus said unto Philip, Philip said, if you show us the Father, I will be satisfied. Jesus now said in verse 9, Jesus said unto him, have I been so long with you, and yet have you not known me, Philip? He that has seen me has seen the Father. So Jesus was the ex-major person. So see, Jesus, the will of God in action. Let's just continue quickly. Number 5, well, I thought I would be able to go further again. Well, I'll just stop where I need to stop. Healing is always God's will. 46, that's number 7 now. Because of the Father heart of God. He says, behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. And that is what we are. J.B. Phillips says, our inheritance on the Godward side, our hereditary on the Godward side, is not a mere figure of speech. That is what we are. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, should be called the sons of God. God is our Father. He says, do not err, my beloved. James 1:16-17. Every good gift and every perfect gift comes from above. From the Father of lights, in whom there is neither variableness nor shadow of turning. Of his own will, he gave back to us with his word of truth. Well, I didn't beg him. I've used that scripture, has delivered me from many problems in life. When I was in university, I'd just go to the sports center, wish to pray, and say, well, I'll just quote the scripture. Well, I've come again. But of your own free will, you get back to me with your word of truth. I did. Hallelujah. It's never failed. I always come out of it. Well, once I stand and ask, forget it, I've won. Because of his own will, he gave back to us with his word of truth. But now let's stop this. As I was saying, now we've taken about 7 today. I'll continue again tomorrow, no problem. Because I always want to take it as I'm talking about praying to receive answers. Matthew chapter 17, as I begin to round up. Matthew 17. Jesus was on the Mount of the Transfiguration. He came down from the mountain and see what happened. Let me start from verse 14. And when they were, Matthew 17:14. And when they were come to the multitude, there came to him a certain man kneeling down to him and saying, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he is lunatic and sore vexed, for oft times he falls into the fire, oft into the water. It was 8:16. And I brought him to your disciples, and they could not cure him or heal him. Verse 17. Then Jesus answered and said, O faithless and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him to me. Then Jesus rebuked the devil, and he departed out of him, and the child was cured from that very hour. Verse 19. Then came the disciples to Jesus apart and said, why could not we cast him out? See what Jesus said. Jesus said unto them, because of your unbelief, for verily I say unto you, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, you shall say unto this mountain, remove hence to yonder place, and shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible unto you. Let's stop there. Genesis chapter 18 also. No, Genesis is not 18. Genesis chapter 16. You see our mother in faith called Sarah. Genesis chapter 16. Sarah said, since the Lord has withheld me from having children. But the Lord withhold her? No, the Lord did not. The Lord did not withhold her. Genesis chapter 16, verse 1. Now Sarah, Abraham's wife, bare him no children. And she had an handmaid, an Egyptian, whose name was Hagar. Verse 2. And Sarah said unto Abraham, behold now, the Lord has restrained me from bearing. I pray thee, go in unto my maid, and it may be that I may obtain children by her. And Abraham hearkened to the voice of Sarah. The Lord had what? Restrained me. But the Lord restrained her. Do you know the same thing now? That's why I want to address something now. You've been studying God's word. You've been hearing God's word. And it seems your healing has not manifested. You're even growing worse instead of better. Now say, it seems the Lord has restrained me from being healed. That is not God's will for me to be healed. That man too that brought his disciples, the child to the disciples, he could have left the place and said, it wasn't God's will for my child to be healed. But was it God's will? No, God wanted the child healed. Praise God. What do we do when we face such situations? Number one, I said, we'll go over what you've done again. Number one, find out what is the will of God. And the will of God is that himself took your infirmities and bore your sicknesses. The will of it is that, beloved, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. The will of God is that be fruitful and multiply. The will of God is that you shall serve the Lord your God. He will bless your bread and water, and he will take sickness away from the midst of thee. And nothing shall, there shall nothing be barren nor cast a young in your land. And the number of your days I will fulfill. That is the will of God. So number one, I said, from my note, I said number one, find out what the will of God is. But that's not enough. After finding the will of God, number two, you must embrace that will. You must embrace that will. How do you embrace it? You meditate on it, you ruminate on it, you think about it. You embrace that will as yours. You agree with God. Sarah finally agreed with God in Genesis, because Hebrews says, Hebrews told us that by faith she received strength. So she changed her mind later. So you must embrace that will, that this is the will of God concerning me in Christ Jesus. That himself took my infirmities and bore my sicknesses. That I am fruitful and I multiply. That is God's will for me, that I be fruitful and multiply. You embrace the will of God. You don't just find it. You embrace it. You agree with it as yours. Hallelujah. Can two walk together except they be agreed? You want something from him. He said, if you abide in me and my words abide, find their place in you. What does that mean? You have embraced his word as his will, and it has become your will. I don't want you to give up on your healing because you've not seen anything manifest. Because I want to tell you that the motive behind your healing is bigger than you. It's God. God has a plan for your life. He says, with long life will he satisfy you and show you his salvation. So he's more interested in you. Did you go and ask God when he made that promise? Did we go and beg him? He said, with long life. Abraham was doing his own journey in Genesis chapter 14. They had captured Lot, his nephew. He went to rescue Lot, and he came back, and he gave all the people the money, just paid tithe out of it, and then gave the people of the other spoils of the war. And Bible says in Genesis 15 verse 1, God came to him himself, that fear not, Abraham, I am your shield. I am your exceeding great reward. Abraham said, yes, I understand you are my shield, but you've not given me any child now. So will Eliezer of Damascus, Abraham was not even asking for a child. He was saying, will Eliezer of my Damascus be my heir? God said, no, it will not be your heir. He said, out of your own loins a child will come. From then on, it was no longer Abraham trying to convince God to give him a child. Go and read Genesis 15. It was God trying to convince Abraham that he was going to give him a child. That's what he said in Genesis. The same thing. We saw a drama of 3 John 2. Beloved, I wish. I initiated the wish above all things that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. I wish. It is my own desire. That's what happened in Genesis 15. It was God convincing Abraham. After that, once Abraham said, this thing is bothering me, if Eliezer is going to be my heir, well, it's okay. At least I have an heir. He said, no, Eliezer is not going to be. Someone born from your own loins will be your heir. And what did God do next? He said, God said, come out in the night. He said, look at the stars. He said, so shall your seed be. He said, look at the sand by the seashore. So shall the multitudes of our seed be. He didn't even stop there. Bible says, and Abraham believed in the Lord. Verse 6. And it was counted to him for righteousness. And God didn't even stop there. God even came down to his level and came to cut a covenant with him. He said, take this animal, take this animal, cut it into 2 and 9. And he walked through it, and God walked through it like a pillar of fire. What was he doing? He was trying to, but the fact that God said it was enough. He didn't need to cut all that physical covenant. God didn't need it. Bible says in Hebrews chapter 6 that by 3 immutable things, it was impossible for God to lie. So for God to have said it was enough. So are you sick in your body? Are you having symptoms that seem not to have gone and they become debilitated? They are getting worse. I have good news for you. God is more interested in you being healed than you are interested in taking that healing. But that means you must not give up. Because the motive behind your healing is the glory of God. Is the goodness of God manifesting to mankind. Hallelujah. People will get born again because you are going to share your testimony. But first, as I say, find the will of God, then embrace that will. What I mean by embrace that will, you don't entertain any other thing. No other thought, no other idea. The devil will come, he might come 365 times in one day. He might come 500 times in one day and tell you that, with this pain in your body, with this situation, I tell you, forget it. You are going to Start planning your funeral. Start giving them money where you save all the money, all the property, because you're going to die. But I have good news for you. You stay with God. Embrace his, he said, beloved, as for me, I wish above all things that you prosper and you be in hell, so you're not going to die. You embrace that word. You embrace it. You embrace it and you eradicate every doubt and every voice that speaks contrary. Hallelujah. If you give a child ice cream, hallelujah, you give a child ice cream, the ice cream he likes. And some kids are looking at me now. You give a child the ice cream he likes. Maybe he likes vanilla flavor and chocolate with some strawberry. And you give him one big ice cream cone. And he's holding, especially a small boy between 1 and 5 or 2 and 5, and he's holding it. I want to give him good food. He won't release the ice cream. He must finish. This is the one where he will embrace the ice cream until he finishes it. But we must, the same house, we must hold fast to what we have. You must embrace it that no, this is the will of God for me. Hallelujah. Now, when you've embraced that, then we can now talk to methods of obtaining that healing. We'll talk about those methods. I might start tomorrow. But you must first embrace that will. I agree that this is the will of God for me. Because the prayer of faith works that when we release our faith, it's called the prayer of faith because it's a prayer based on only what God has revealed in his word. That is why it is prayer of faith. Even though it should have called a prayer of senses. It's a prayer of faith because the only evidence that prayer is answered is the word of God. So you embrace that word. So I have good news for you. Bible says, Ephesians chapter 6 as I close. Having done all to stand, stand. Embrace what the word has said and stand with it. Himself took my infirmities and bore my sicknesses. Surely he has borne my sicknesses and carried my pains. He was wounded for my transgressions, bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement of my peace was upon him, with his stripes I was healed. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10. Now beginning to close today, we'll continue tomorrow. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God and be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against the spiritual wickedness in high places. Just calling them names, they are not powerful. Bible says, Colossians 15, that Jesus has paralyzed principalities and powers. The same ones he mentioned here. So they are not powerful. So that's not like, he's from home. He's from the village. He said, Jesus, Paul said that what you need to do, the Holy Ghost through Paul, is that finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Don't be strong in the knowledge of he's from the village. Be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle our dealing, literally what it means is our dealing, is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities. That means you should not fight anybody. Don't be grudging anybody because your feeling is not with flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. But Bible says in Colossians 2:15. When I read this, I always like to quote in Colossians 2:15. That having paralyzed the same principalities and powers. Please put Colossians 2:15 on the screen. He made a show of them openly. So the principalities I'm dealing with are paralyzed principalities. They are paralyzed principalities and powers. What if you think it was a personality, a power that gave you cancer? It's a paralyzed personality and power. So that cancer must go. Let's continue reading. Now, people say, it's from the village. Whatever. But it's an attack. Verse 13 now says, wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that I'm able to stand against the wiles of stand in the evil day. And having done all to stand, he said, stand, therefore. So you stand on what you have embraced. You stand on what you believe and what you embrace. One of the ways to keep standing, that is what will be coming from your mouth. Eradicate every doubt, every thought that says that what you want from God is not yours. How do you eradicate those doubts? Jesus told us in Matthew chapter 4. Matthew chapter 3, devil appeared to Jesus. Jesus went to be baptized in Jordan. And a voice came from everybody. This is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. The devil no grieved still. He went to the wilderness. The devil said, all that one, Nashu, if you are really the son of God, you will not be hungry. But you see what the devil used his flesh. He experienced that he was fasting and he was hungry. He said, now turn stone to bread, because if you are really the Son of God, turn stone to bread, you will not be hungry. Jesus said, my being the Son of God is not because I can turn stone to bread. It's not whether I'm hungry or not. It's because God has said it. That's what happened. That's why Jesus replied, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. And it has proceeded from the mouth of God that I'm his child, so I'm his son of God. It doesn't matter what you feel. So the same way, by his stripes I was healed. He has said it, and that's what matters. The Lord said he will take away from thee all sickness. So he has taken it because he does not lie. That's what he is, the Lord my healer. That is what matters. When you've embraced the will of God, then what you do next? Then now you can ask. We'll continue tomorrow. Now you can make a petition. But you see, you are why I want to emphasize today that when you release your faith with all those, we have about 7 methods of obtaining healing. Of course, one of them is according to his, by, as the spirit wills, by the spirit will talk, but as it keeps by the spirit wills. But every other of the other 6 methods, once you act on any one of them, you are acting on it based on the word of God, not based on your senses. There's something I always ask myself when I pray a prayer of faith about anything personal. And thoughts, that was when I prayed, I released my faith for something. It was taking long, like 6 months, a year, nothing was happening. And then we'll bring thoughts that it wasn't about healing, about some of the property or something like that. And then we'll bring that, this thing will never come to pass. Know where I go? I'll go back to the scriptures. I normally type the scriptures I use in a file. Info. I'll go back to the scriptures and say, well, why did I believe that I received it when I prayed? Was it because it seemed physically it was going to come to pass? No. The only reason why I was sure that I received it when I prayed was because of the word. And these scriptures have not changed. So I still believe I receive it. Mark 11:24. We'll continue tomorrow. It says, what things soever you desire, when you pray. I like to say when you release your faith, because you can release your faith by praying, can release it by saying. Believe that you receive, and you shall have. Many people are going to take their healing this last 2 weeks of this month. Why? Because you've heard the word of God. You've embraced the word of God since, yes. Well, have you acted and released your faith and believe that moment I release my faith, I receive it, it is done. That himself took my infirmities. Oh, I cannot tell you stories. I've had terrible symptoms in my body. The devil said that this one, you are not going to get well. That this one is going to finish you. But I just released my faith. Himself took my infirmities and bore my sins. Therefore, I say I'm healed in the name of Jesus. I took it by saying, I know the word of God and I say I'm healed. And I keep going my way. Sometimes I've been going my way that I thought, I'm not saying... That was me. I was a bit extreme. I got my way that I thought it was as if I was going to faint and drop dead. But I didn't drop dead. Because I wasn't acting on my words. I was acting based on what he had said. See, that's why I said, first take time. Find out what the will of God is. Take your time. When you found out the will of God, then embrace it totally. Embrace it what? Totally. That, well, this is what God says. This is why I agree with. Another step you should do after that, doesn't apply to everybody, make sure you are not living in sin. Make sure you are living in fellowship with God. If you are living in broken fellowship, restore that fellowship. And it's very easy to restore. Father, I'm sorry I messed up. I'm sorry in Jesus' name. That's as simple as that. Don't be living persistently in wrongdoing. I said persistently. Persistently. And expect to reach. Your faith will not be bold towards God if you do that. Your faith will not be bold towards. I think I will just stop there and continue tomorrow. I'm not in a rush. So you've listened some today. Go over this message. We'll continue again tomorrow. But your healing is God's will. The same way you pray, the same God that answers. E.W. Kenyon said something. He said, every answer to prayer is a miracle. Every answer to prayer is a miracle. You prayed for 10,000, you got it. You prayed for a new job, you got it. You prayed for a better job, you got it. Every answer to the same way you will release your faith concerning that cancer. Maybe something like a growth around your head somewhere here. And it will go too. And you will get it too. The same way. We'll continue tomorrow. Father, we give you praise for himself, took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. Thank you, Father God, that surely he has borne our sicknesses and carried our pains. Why not let's affirm ourselves? Just affirm, embrace those truths again. Say, thank you, Father. Surely Jesus has borne my sicknesses and carried my pains. He was wounded for my transgressions. He was bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement of my peace was upon him, and with his stripes I have been healed. The word says, who his own self bore my sins in his own body on the tree, that I, being dead to sins, might live unto righteousness, by whose stripes you were, I was healed. Hallelujah. Surely he has borne my sicknesses and carried my pains. Surely he has borne my sicknesses and carried my pains. Surely he has borne my sicknesses and carried my pains. Himself took my infirmities and bore my sicknesses. If he took your infirmities, that means you are not infirmed. The devil is just playing tricks on you. We are going to act on God's word and take our healing. Maybe, maybe it's Friday. Whenever we act on it finally and minister or whatever we are led to do, and that we pray or minister lay hands, once that is done, she can have it settled. You are healed. Because we walk by faith and not by sight. The centurion said, only speak the word. That is all I need. And my servant shall be made whole. Hallelujah. Stay with God's word. Embrace God's word. Find out the will of God and embrace it totally. Father, we give you praise for today. This is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad in it. Find the spirit of wisdom and moderation losing our mistake for the truth of your word coming clearer and clearer and stronger in our lives. In Jesus' name. Amen. Father, as we give our offerings, we give you the heart of God, joy and gratitude because you are good and your mercies endure forevermore. We are not praying for our healing. Jesus is ready to get up. Thank you, Father God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. This is Rema Nigeria. Rema Bible Training Center, Nigeria. It's a Bible school. It's not just a healing school. The healing school is an outreach arm of the Bible school. And we're in six centers. We're in Lagos, Abuja, Kaduna, Nasarawa State, Enugu, and Port Harcourt. Lagos, Kaduna, Abuja, Nasarawa State, Enugu, and Port Harcourt. Want to apply for Bible school? Don't have to be a preacher. Anybody come to Bible school. We have admissions going on for the October intake. Just go to our site, www.remanigeria.com/apply. I'll say it again. www.remanigeria.com/apply. Rema is spelled R-H-R-H-E-M-A. remanigeria.com/apply. And you come to school and you never, word, your life will never remain the same because the entrance of his word gives light. Gives understanding to the simple. Hallelujah. So see you again this evening. There's a weekly healing school. We'll be here by 4 p.m. again this evening. And tomorrow, 12 noon, every working day, except there's a public holiday, we have daily healing school. We're in plot 517 Nola Crescent in Worcester Zone 5, Abuja. Bring the sick. He sent his word and healed them. And delivered them from the destruction. See you again tomorrow or this evening. Blessed. You're the same.